We collared Azoba in 2009, April, and we collared him in the valley of Junnar. So leopards occur all over India in all kinds of places. They are there in the peri-urban landscape, like Mumbai, outskirts of Bangalore, in and out of Guwahati, near Delhi. So they occur in a lot of landscapes, it's just that we are not aware of it. He was released at the boundary of two districts, Pune and Thane. It was quite surprising because I thought he will go eastwards, but he started going, northwards and westwards, and his movements were not confused. And his movements indicated that he knew where he was going. And then one day I saw that his point was in Vasai Industrial Estate, which is a very built-up area with a lot of people, and I really panicked. But then I realized they were 3-day-old signals, and he hadn't done anything because there was nothing reported. 2, 3, 4 weeks into his travel, and then I knew it, that he's just probably going to Bombay. So we believe he may have been originally caught from Bombay and released somewhere else, and he was on his way back. But this is just a surmise. And it was really fascinating because he crossed the Mumbai-Agra highway, he crossed the Kasara railway station, he crossed two protected areas, and then went to the third, which was Sanjay Gandhi National Park, where he settled. For 2 years, he just lived there itself. He died there. He died in a road accident over there. A vehicle hit him, which is also a very fascinating story. This man, he picked up this pretty heavy leopard weighing around 70 kilos and put it in the trunk of his car. Azoba was still alive then, although not conscious. And his family was also in the car, which is like amazing. Imagine having a full leopard in the boot of your car. And he drove him to Sanjay Gandhi National Park, where he was, he was dead by the time he reached there. The reportage of conflicts definitely outnumber the reportage of, just neutral incidences, because when I was working in the rural landscape, I used to have these farmers who'd call me every evening and say, "Oh, he just walked past my door." But this will never be a story, right? It's like you can never have a story which says leopard walked past door, right? But leopard attacks a human being is definitely a story. So it is also the perception of the problem. The only difference, which is very serious, is that animals can't stand up and explain why they did what they did, whereas human beings can.